Hello, I'm Larissa Rubijewski with Remax Bellas Verdes.
Hi, I'm Mike Bjork of First Cal Mortgage, and welcome to South Bay Market Report.
Today, we're going to be talking about things that you should know about the internet. Things might not be accurate, so check it out. To the general website related to the real estate, and there are tons of them out there. How accurate they are, that's a big question. I actually see a lot of upset buyers and a lot of upset sellers because the information that they're getting on the general websites sometimes just so far from the truth. For example, people are checking the comps in the area. How much my house worth in that particular month in comparisons to, let's say, last year? What are my projections? Sometimes internet and those sites are giving you such a outrageous information, you are either up by 25% or down by 25%. Now, the conflict of interest is that not only you as a seller looking at that, but also somebody as a buyer looking at your property trying to establish the value of your home. The internet is a cold monster. There is a lot of controversies going on right now, and I think you just have to be very careful and selective in terms of digesting the numbers and the data. Now, in terms of the mortgages and loans, I'm pretty sure that you guys are getting hit hard too.
We run into lots of situations where people are looking for interest rates on the internet, and some of the places they may be looking for interest rates aren't actually a lender. They might be looking at some other search engine site out there where they might be just throwing interest rates out there, which doesn't take into account all the different variables that we look at to provide you an accurate interest rate. And when you look at those interest rates, they're actually, because they're not a lender, they're not obligated to give you that interest rate. So those are things you really need to be careful about.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, another issue with a real estate search, let's say you would like to check if that property is available or not. You go on some of the sites that we don't like, and but maybe friendly and seem to be quite credible, and you see, yes, that house is available, fully furnished, beautiful price. You check back with your realtor and the house been sold 3 months ago. How frustrated that can be. We would invite you again to trust reliable sources. Go on MLS, go to your realtor, go to your mortgage broker. Make sure that they would provide the tools for you in terms of accuracy for the search. MLS information is the most updated, and that's accurate up to the point that they are renewing the data every 15 minutes. Rest of the site, sometimes it takes them 72 plus hours to get the data processed. So, not only that, I think also many people get very confused about the property status. For example, a couple of my clients were absolutely frustrated to find their home listed on some of the general use sites as a pre-foreclosure, or there was some notice of default, or somebody saw my house is up for auction. What is going on? So, please be careful before you digest this information or jump into any conclusion about any distress towards the property. Check with a realtor, check with your broker. Make sure that you're not offending people who might still live there and have no idea what's going on in all those dark waters. Anything else to add to that?
Yeah, another item to watch out for is some of these companies that will do a pre-qualification online where you just submit a bunch of information to them, and all those are really is capturing your information to solicit, so now you become a lead for another sales group. And essentially, the information that they're collecting from you is not really a pre-qual, because it takes a lot more than 10-15 minutes to go through all your tax returns and everything else to determine what you're actually pre-approved for. And what we look at, what you may think you might be paid, may be completely different. So really be careful about the internet, because it can be very misleading what you really are qualified for.
Well, the bottom line is usually as simple as everything is genius as simple. Just talk to your broker and get connected directly to the direct source, to this mothership of all the information. And I think you will benefit from that a lot. Again, there is no obligations for that. We'll just get your email, hook it up to the MLS or to another sources that you can trust for the accuracy of it at least, and we'll be happy to provide any further information that you need. Again, I'm Larissa with RE/MAX PV.
And I'm Mike Bjork of First Cal Mortgage. And also please subscribe to our channel.
Good idea. Thanks a lot for tuning in.